breeding super healthy people and super fit people and who want to be fit and healthy. So together for sure we can get our aims. And yes, don't believe any single words that I'm saying. What I want to you, make your own research and find the information you need. But still, in my case, I'll be glad to share information what I have, what works well for me from the research I done and so on. So today I want to discuss about sleeping. So we already talked about clean air, clean water, good nutrition, regime, exercises and so on. But what about sleeping? Unfortunately, our body, yeah, it is developed well, it working amazingly good, especially if we make a research in anatomy and biology, but it's not that good. Yes, I know we have like some people who, let's say, quite unique. They never sleep and feel absolutely fine, but this syndrome is quite rare, maybe one person on 100,000 or so on. So it's really, really rare. But mostly people, if you not have enough sleep, you will not feel good, I would say. And for our health, unfortunately, we need to sleep enough and in the right time. So then we not only can increase our results, we can feel better. So I'll just mention a few points what I want to. So I made an experiment when I stay in temple, had a really cool task, need stay without sleeping as long as you can. So usually one, like 24 hours, it's fine. And second day you're already tired, you're slow, you're stupid, but still you can do it. But when you're on a third day, it seems like almost impossible. You cannot keep the attention on when people talk to you and so on. And I drink coffee and tea, whatever, it doesn't help. And you're like a zombie. And on the fourth day, I just knock out and I just sleep, that's it. And you know, after that you understand, so after a couple of days you're a super super weak person, so you just not sleep a little bit and that's it, you're totally broke. And our body works in a really interesting way. We need to sleep because our hormone grow, it's produced only when we're sleeping. Our testosterone produced not only when we work out, when we sleep as well after the sleeping. So basically in the morning you have peak of that. And a lot of the process what going on about recovering, even your fat burning basically is going when you're sleeping. So if you sleep not enough, you missed all of that points. So basically when we awake, it's work one kind of process, and when we are sleeping, body take care of all of the other process what they need to recover. If you have some micro injuries and other things, and when it take energy, it's take energy from fat. But big guys who are like, let's say, over the 100 kilo, 130, professional bodybuilders, yeah, they need drink at least some protein shakes in the evening, or take some eggs or maybe cottage cheese, have a little bit of protein for keep the muscle on, because everything what we don't need, body just get rid of it straight away. So if you have too much muscle, what need additional energy for take care, need more blood for support all of the muscles. So for body, it's much easier for take it off. At least if you're not genetically big, if you're all of the grandparents working hard, have a lot of muscles on their body, so probably genetically you will be big and your body will be take care of it because you have a certain program. In other case, it will be quite difficult for keep it on. So when we need to sleep, in the best case, if you go sleep 9 or 10 a.m. or 9 or 10 p.m. because the peak of the produce of the hormone growth is about midnight, but you should be reached to the fast dreaming state, so take about 2 hours. It's mean if you go sleep 9 or 10, you will reach that peak and you will take a maximum hormone growth you can. This means you get more recovery, you feel better and so on. And when I was super busy, I need to complete my works and so on, you go like 2 or 3 a.m., you wake up in the morning even later, it's still, you feel not the same if you go to sleep 9, 10 p.m. and you wake up 5 or 6, you on completely, totally level of energy, totally level of mood, you can complete much more things because in the morning your productivity much, much higher. And from my experience, I can say so, I complete 3 times more in my project because I finish my training, I go to sleep, wake up 6, I start to work on my project, make my yoga, lunchtime, whatever, and I done way, way more. But basically, I'm not that professional. I work in, like, let's say, in similar speed and so on. But my day way more productive compared to other people with who I work to. It's a simple example. Additionally, I feel myself like just great, much, much better. And many stories would probably I heard from many people, like, wake up in the morning and have no power, lazy. You just wake up, should be totally recovered and have no power. So probably nutrition, so lifestyle is totally different. Or like some people said, wake up and feel like broke, cannot move and so on. So yeah, we can do the morning exercise, will be helpful. So unfortunately, yeah, our body work in that way, like a biological robots need a restart, make upgrades every day, otherwise it's not work well. And if you wanna get some really good sport results and you will sleep not enough, it will not work. I was busy a few times in my life, so I sleep only like 4, maximum 5 hours a day. It's during 1-2 months, and you know, you feel sucks. You feel just extremely tired, and after that, I always feel hungry. I just eat it. I cannot feed myself, so probably energy losses is huge. Additionally, sleep quite a long time and still I have that hunger to the sleep more, so this balance body cannot reach like months time maybe. And when you're really exhausted, you cannot train in the same way. So even when you do the light training every day, you're not working on 200%, so it's totally different. So what I want to say, like, is sleep enough and in the right time, it's really, really important. Some people I know, they go sleeping late, so they can take a nap and then noontime. So if you have such wonderful job or so on, yeah, why not? Basically, in many Asian countries, people have a tradition like sleeping in noontime, especially in Vietnam. So if you respect yourself, you have to sleep in the noontime at least 1 or 2 hours. So people who not sleep at that time, they like not take care of themselves, and probably it's like black laborers who like working really hard, and all other people, they try to. Because they wake up like 4 a.m. when it's not hot, they can do all of the work they can, same like in other tropical country where it's really hot. They wake up 4 a.m., do all of this job, and when it gets really hot, they go to sleep, wake up when the heat go down and complete all other things and go sleep early as well. Usually it's like around 9-10 p.m. when it's get dark already, nothing to do outside and so on. And probably this natural life of being with the nature, it's quite perfect. When I go to the hiking, same. When it's dark, you don't have TV, you have no internet, you can watch the skies a little bit, some night animals, that's it. You're going to sleep, wake up like on a sunrise at 5 a.m. and walk, and basically all of the week you walking and with high distances, like, I don't know, 30 kilometers even more, and you feel fine actually. And in my opinion, because not only about clean air and water, you sleep enough, you recover yourself totally, you have all of the hormones you need, bam. Then if you not sleep, we have another hormones what called cortisol and oh my God, what is name? It's kind of destructive hormones body producing a high level of stress. So if you're always in the stress or depression, you have destructive hormones what produce in your body what not really good for you. So basically you break yourself by yourself, let's say. So it will be cool if you can share more information about, maybe you know something more, or I don't know, but it will be good if you can make a research by yourself about. So it's really big difference when someone tell you this thing and when you can pick it up from somewhere by yourself, when you study it, read it, learn it by yourself, so you can get much more understanding. Because if I get into the details how the sleeping process working, we go to the alpha, beta, gamma state and so on, it will be like hours of talking, and with complicated language it's not really easy. Instead I explain in 2 words, need sleep more. So usually it's about 6 hours at least. Can sleep 8? Okay, you can try and see, because of course if you're working hard, like physically, and then you have a workout and so on, high level of stress, maybe you need much more time for recover. Also, I notice when I sleep only 5-6 hours a day and meditate about half an hour a day. So basically it kind of recover because you go in the same state with no thoughts. So basically meditation, it's same like you go to the sleeping state, but sometimes you can meditate in sleep. So basically it's between sleeping and awareness. So have no thoughts and you really relaxed state and you feel just good. It's same like you sleep, for sure. Because sometimes when you're really tired, even you take a nap like 15-20 minutes, you feel better already. So from meditation, when you meditate right, have no thoughts, totally relax. So for some people it might take a month until they get to that state. It's probably all of the same process starts for recover the body and everything. So maybe people who do the yoga, that's why they look that good, much younger than they are, less fat body level and so on. Because yeah, if someone wanna get rid of the fat body and sleep not enough, it will be quite difficult task because yeah, when we are sleeping, our body work on the fat, not only the during activity or cardio or whatever. All right, what else can I add? I think it's quite enough and I hope I was comprehensive. So I want to be short and notice only important things for you to pick it up, because some people say, oh, I cannot gain in weight, my results is not growing, and like with not balancing nutrition, it's not really possible. If your regime not good for that, it will be not possible also. You're not drinking enough water, clean water I mean, and you're not sleeping enough, of course you will not get the best results possible. All right, so next time we will discuss more things about how to be fit and healthy. So stay tuned, see you soon.